Le futur proche, so basically if you want to translate it directly, it would be the near future. So what is le futur proche exactly? It's the possibility that we have in French and in other languages to construct basically a future with aller at the present form, followed by the infinitive, so the basic form of the verb. Okay, so like in English, you would say, I am going to travel, for instance. In French, we would say, je vais voyager. Okay, so remember first aller that you conjugate at the present form, and then you will put your verb at the infinitive form. Okay, so first, of course, we did introduce the verb aller and the way to conjugate it, but still, I think that it is really important to see how it goes. So we will see one more time the conjugation of aller at the present form. Okay, first person here, je vais. Remember, final S not pronounced. Je vais. Okay, tu vas. Same thing here, final S not pronounced. Tu vas. Il. Elle va. Nous allons. Final S not pronounced. And then when you get this O-N combination, you get this nasal on, really in your nose, okay? On. And then let's make this little liaison here to make it sound more beautiful. Nous allons. Nous allons. Okay? Same thing here. Vous allez. Vous allez. All right, remember, classic ending for vous, a Z, okay, but then when you combine these two letters, you get the sound E, okay, allez, and then vous allez, all right, and the last persons, ils, elles vont, ils vont, elles vont, okay, remember, final T not pronounced, so you get this ON nasal here, on vont. Okay, so let's see them one more time. Je vais, tu vas, il va, elle va, nous allons, vous allez, ils vont, elles vont. Okay, so that's the first part that we will use to construct this futur proche, okay? And then the second part will be, well, the verb that you want to express, but at the infinitive form. So I've been writing few examples here. So the first sentence, je vais voyager. Voyager means to travel. Avec, with, ma famille, my family. Je vais voyager avec ma famille. Okay? So, quite simple way to construct a future form. Tu vas chercher. Chercher means to search. Une nouvelle maison. Okay? Une nouvelle. Nouvelle, it's the feminine form of the adjective nouveau, new. Okay, because maison, house, as you can see here, is feminine. So, une nouvelle maison, a new house. Tu vas chercher une nouvelle maison. Okay? And then, il, elle va partir. Partir is to leave. Okay? Pour means for. Pour un. One year, un an. Okay, so I will make the liaison just to make it more normal after. Okay, but I just want to divide here, un an. Okay, so let's read it normally now. Il va partir pour un an. Okay, so you can hear that now I make this link between the two. Un an, un an. So no break between the two. Un an. Okay. Il va partir pour un an. Elle va partir pour un an. Okay? Then for nous. Nous allons chanter. Chanter means to sing. Okay? Cette chanson. So remember, cette feminine form of ce, this. Okay, chanson, song, and as chanson is feminine, so you should put this form here at the feminine. This, okay? Nous allons chanter cette chanson. Nous allons chanter cette chanson. And then for vous, vous allez adorer. So adorer, to adore, to love a lot. Ce film, okay? So you see now this, okay? But then it's the masculine form because film here is masculine. Ce film, this movie, okay? Vous allez adorer ce film. Vous allez adorer ce film. And the last one. Ils vont boire, boire is to drink, un café, a coffee. Ils vont boire un café. Elles vont boire un café. Okay, so let's repeat everything again. Je vais voyager avec ma famille. Tu vas chercher une nouvelle maison. Il va partir pour un an. Elle va partir pour un an. Nous allons chanter cette chanson. Vous allez adorer ce film. Ils vont boire un café. Elles vont boire un café. Bonjour à tous, hi everyone and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 4, leçon B. And in this lesson, sorry, we'll try to work on le genre des mots, so the gender of the words, because normally that's something a bit difficult for students to know or to remember the gender of the words. So normally what I tell them is to try to memorize, try to remember the gender when they discover or when they see a new word, but I know it's not easy. Okay, so in this lesson we'll try to see actually a few endings that give you some useful tips, and well, we'll focus only on the feminine words, and we'll start right now. Sorry. So when you see words that are ending with this E-O-N, so you can be almost. This is quite important. Never say always when you talk about French language, because you always find some exceptions. Okay, so I won't say always. I will say in most of the cases. Okay, when they end with E-O-N, okay, they in most of the cases they will be feminine. Okay, so for instance here, la libération, or then la nation. Okay. Other ending is t, so when a word is finishing or ending with t, like that, la rapidité. Rapidité means speed, and then la santé, health. Okay, in this case, you can be almost sure that these words will be feminine. Okay, when they're ending with ure, ur, okay, la peinture, paint, la voiture, car, okay, so they are feminine. And then when they're ending with s, like that, e, s, so for instance, la politesse, la vitesse. Vitesse means speed. Okay, so these words are feminine, and these endings are classical ending for feminine form. Okay, so let's see them one more time. La libération, la nation, la rapidité, la santé, la peinture, la voiture, la politesse, la vitesse. Okay, so let's see a few more. So still for the feminine form. So when you will have a word ending with this double T, et, okay, for instance, la chaussette, la roulette, so they will be feminine, okay? Chaussette means sock, and then roulette, well, it's the same, the thing you will find in casinos. And then when they're ending with IE, like here, Okay, so basically you don't pronounce the E, okay, so it will be only the sound I, okay, for instance, la vie, life, okay, la partie, the part, okay, so there will be feminine as well, okay, and then words ending with E, accent aigu, and then E here, okay, remember this final E is not pronounced, so you will have this E, remember, accent aigu, it's E. Sound, okay. La poupée, the doll. L'arrivée, the arrival, okay. La poupée, l'arrivée. So feminine as well. In that case, remember that normally it should be la arrivée, but as arrivée, as usual, you know, start with a vowel, then a is disappearing, and then you just put this apostrophe, okay. And then words ending with ude, like that, ude. Ud, okay, are normally, in most of the cases, feminine. La gratitude. Well, if my understanding is correct, it's exactly the same in English. La gratitude, and then same thing here. Latitude. Latitude. Okay, so let's repeat them one more time. La chaussette. La roulette. La vie. La partie. La poupée, l'arrivée, la gratitude, l'attitude. Okay, I know it's not the key. It's not the magic key that will help you forever and that will give you all the time the correct gender of the words, but still you've got some tips now. Okay, it was leçon B. Okay, remember that I've been doing many lessons, so they can be found there on youtube.com/imagier, okay, and then the website is here, imagier.net. You can find more material there. Have a nice day. Bye bye. L'article partitif. So what's l'article partitif? Well, basically it's when you want to say that you want some sugar, for instance, so you don't want to specify the quantity. Okay, just want to say that you want some, but you don't want to say one, two, three. Okay, then as usual, we will have the difference between the masculine form and the feminine form. Okay, so for the masculine form, it will be du. Okay, du. Simple thing, de, u. This is u, this is de, du. All right. And then for the feminine form, it will be de la. Okay? De la. All right? Masculine form, du. Feminine form, de la. All right? Let's see a few examples now. Je bois. Boire is to drink. Okay? So, je bois du café. All right? So, you can see the difference here. It would be possible to say je bois un café. Okay? In that case, you would translate it je bois un café by I drink one coffee or I drink a coffee. Okay? In that case, when you put this du café, so first you put the masculine form because café is masculine. Okay? And then you want to say, you don't want to specify the quantity, you want to say I drink some coffee, okay? Je bois du café, okay? The other option as well would be to say je bois le café. So if you want to put this article défini, but then you would have to put more information after le café de ma mère, the coffee of my mother, if you want. Okay? So in that case, in this lesson, we'll only focus on l'article partitif. So it's some, okay? Je bois du café. All right, let's see another option. Tu voudrais. So I wanted to introduce this voudrais form. Okay, so it's coming from vouloir. Vouloir is to want. Okay, but then it's not the present form here, the classic present form. It's the conditionnel form. Okay, so it's the polite form that normally we should use. So, I would like to have, you know, you don't say tu veux, you don't say you want, because It is too strong and too direct. So normally we tend to use this conditionnel form. So tu voudrais, you would like to have, and then salade, okay? And it's feminine, so you should put the feminine form of this participe. So de la salade. So some salad, okay? Tu voudrais de la salade. All right. Let's see another example here. Nous mangeons. So manger is to eat, okay? And that's the form for nous, okay? Nous mangeons du gâteau. Gâteau is cake, okay? And it's masculine, so du gâteau. We eat some cake. Vous voulez. Okay, so vouloir again. All right, to want. Okay, but here it's the present form. Okay, do you want? Vous voulez du fromage, cheese? Du fromage, so some cheese. And it's a question. Vous voulez du fromage? Okay, and the last example here. So I've been putting this il y a. We'll see that a bit later in this unit, but it will come. Il y a means there is. Okay, il y a, there is. Okay, il y a de la neige. Neige is snow. Okay, par terre, on the ground, par terre. So there is snow on the ground. Il y a de la neige par terre. Okay, so let's repeat all these sentences. The first one, je bois du café. Second one, tu voudrais de la salade? Nous mangeons du gâteau. Vous voulez du fromage? It's a question, so I've been insisting a little bit too much, maybe. Let's do it one more time. Vous voulez du fromage? And the last one, il y a de la neige par terre. Pourquoi? Why? Pourquoi? Why? Okay? So, if you ask a question with pourquoi, why, normally the answer that you will have will start with whether, parce que, because, okay, or then pour, plus one verb at the infinitive form, so the basic form, okay? So whether, parce que, and then you just start a sentence, or then pour, plus the verb at the infinitive form, okay? Let's see now some examples. First question. Pourquoi es-tu ici? Pourquoi es-tu ici? Okay? Ici means here. Es-tu, are you? Why are you here? Pourquoi es-tu ici? So the first answer. Parce que, so because, je suis invité, I am invited, par, by Nicolas. Because I am invited by Nicolas. Parce que je suis invité par Nicolas. Okay, so normally when you start with the parce que, so you want to express the reason why, okay? Parce que je suis invité par Nicolas. All right? And then, other option would be pour passer la soirée. So in that case, passer should be translated like spend, okay? Pour, to spend, pour passer la soirée, the evening, avec, with vous, you. Pour passer la soirée avec vous, to spend the evening with you. And in that case, when you will start your answer with pour, okay, so you will express what will you will do after that, okay? Pour passer la soirée avec vous, okay? And in that case, parce que, you want to introduce the reason why, okay? So that's the way we will construct answers when you will ask a question with pourquoi, okay? Où est le cube? Where is the cube? Où est le cube? Okay, so let's see that together. So here, first situation. Here, Okay, so this is le cube and this is le cylindre. Okay, so just to make it clear, because that's the things we'll use to introduce, well, the prepositions. Le cube est sur le cylindre. So you can see it's on. Okay, so sur le cylindre. Okay, and there is contact here. Okay, it's quite important. Second option, same thing, but it's basically under here. Le cube est sous le cylindre. Okay? Le cube est sous le cylindre. Don't pronounce the final S. And then this OU combination of vowels is pronounced OU. Okay? Sous, sous. Le cube est sous le cylindre. All right? Then, here, no contact, and that's really important, okay? Le cube est au-dessus du cylindre. So let's repeat it. Le cube est au-dessus, final S not pronounced here, au-dessus du cylindre. Okay? Then, same situation, sorry, but then the opposite, so it's here and no contact here. You can see no contact. Le cube est au-dessous du cylindre. Okay? Au-dessous, final S not pronounced, du cylindre. Le cube est au-dessous du cylindre. Alright? So, here, I've been putting the plural form because we've got two here. Les cubes sont à côté du cylindre. So, next to, okay? Les cubes sont à côté du cylindre. Le cube est à gauche du cylindre. Okay? Gauche, left. On the left of le cylindre. Le cube est à gauche du cylindre. Okay, then the next one. Droite, obviously it's right, on the right. Le cube est à droite du cylindre. Le cube est à droite du cylindre. Okay, in front of. Le cube est devant le cylindre. Le cube est devant le cylindre. And now, behind, it's not possible to see it, that's the reason why. Le cube est derrière, so behind, le cylindre. Le cube est derrière le cylindre. So I've been taking away the color just to show you that it's inside, okay? So in, le cube est dans, so in, le cylindre. Le cube est dans le cylindre. Les adverbes de lieu. So really useful, and we're starting right now. So the first one that we'll see, so I've been putting each time the English first and then the French version here. Okay, so here. So I won't read the English one. I will focus on the French one if that's okay with you. Ici. Ici. Okay? Then là. So remember you've got this accent but well you don't pronounce it. Okay? So it's là. Là. Oops. Là-bas. Là-bas. Remember final S not pronounced. Là-bas. Loin. Loin. So remember when you get this combination O I N, it's loin, loin, loin. Okay. Loin. All right. So let's see them one more time. Ici. Là, là-bas, loin. OK? Devant, final T not pronounced. Devant. Devant. Derrière. So if you look carefully, you've got E here and then double R, so it will open the sound of this E and you should pronounce it E, okay? De. Derrière. Same thing here, you've got this E accent grave, E. Derrière. Okay? Don't pronounce the final E. Derrière. Okay? Final S not pronounced. Dessus. 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 Dessous. Dessous. Final S not pronounced here. Dessous. Okay, so let's repeat them. Devant. Derrière. Dessus. Dessous. Okay? Dedans. Final S not pronounced. Dedans. Dedans. Dehors. Okay, so remember, final S not pronounced, and then this H in French doesn't exist phonetically, so you don't pronounce it. Dehors. 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 En haut. En haut. Okay, final T not pronounced, and then this H as previously, you don't pronounce it, so this is O. En haut. En haut. En haut. En bas, final S not pronounced, en bas, en bas, ok? Quelque part, don't pronounce the final T, quelque part, quelque part. Autre part, autre part, autre part. Ailleurs. Look, final S not pronounced, and then you've got this y, y, y sound. Ailleurs. Okay, so I insist a little bit too much maybe, but still, let's read it normally now. Ailleurs. Ailleurs. Okay? Autour. 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 Okay, so repeat them one more time. Quelque part. Autre part, ailleurs, autour. Comment exprimer, sorry, comment exprimer l'obligation? So, when you must do something, well, there is a verb for that, to express must, and this is falloir. Falloir, okay, falloir. And then you will have two options. The first one will be il faut, so you get to remember that falloir is what we call verbe impersonnel, okay, because there is only one form and it's il, third person of the singular. Il faut, okay, so je, tu, nous, vous, etc., they don't exist for falloir, it's only il, okay. Il faut, and then the verb coming after will be at the infinitive. Okay, so that's the way to express to must. Okay, and then, or to have to if you want. Il faut. Okay, same form, but then you will add after that un nom, a noun. Okay, so whether a verb at the infinitive form or then a noun. So we'll see a few examples now. So the first scénario, as we would say in French, is falloir plus infinitif. Okay? So, here, il faut respecter les règles. Alright? Il faut respecter, so to respect, les règles, the rules. Il faut respecter les règles. Alright? And then, another option, so I've been putting here and here the two parts of the negative form. Il ne faut pas fumer. Fumer is to smoke. ici, here. Il ne faut pas fumer ici. Okay, so now we'll see the way it works with noun, a noun. And here, for instance, il faut. So still il faut, remember, as I said, it's only il faut, so it's a verb impersonnel. Okay, une carte d'identité. Il faut une carte d'identité. Second example here. Il faut un parapluie, umbrella, un parapluie, car, because, il pleut. It's raining. It rains. Il faut un parapluie, car il pleut. Les adjectifs ordinaux. Les adjectifs ordinaux, so in English it would be first, second, third, fourth, etc., etc. So we'll see how they go in French. And so we'll start with the first, okay? And as usual in French, remember, we've got the difference between the masculine form and the feminine form, okay? So each time we'll have here and here the masculine form and the feminine form. Here, that's the way you can see them written when you get to make them short, okay? So they can be written like that, okay? So we'll pronounce them. Le premier, so the first, le premier, la première. Le premier, la première. Okay? Then, le deuxième, la deuxième. So in that case, it's only the le and la. That will be different because deuxième will be the same if you look at them. Okay? Then, same thing here. Le troisième, la troisième. Le troisième, la troisième. Okay? Le quatrième, la quatrième. Le quatrième, la quatrième. Le cinquième, la cinquième. Le cinquième, la cinquième. Le sixième, la sixième. Le sixième, la sixième. Le septième, so remember we don't pronounce this P here. Le septième, la septième. Okay? Le huitième, remember H doesn't exist. Huitième, huitième, la huitième. Le neuvième, neuvième, so it's V here, remember, vième, la neuvième. Le neuvième, la neuvième. Le dixième, so remember, even if you've got this Z, X here, you pronounce it Z, dixième, dixième. Same thing as we had here, sixième, okay? Le dixième, la dixième. Le verbe partir, partir means to leave, okay? At the present form. So we see this verb because this verb is normally quite useful. And then it is not regular, so it belongs to the third group of verbs. So it's always good to see the conjugation together, okay? So the first form is je pars. So final S not pronounced. Je pars. Tu pars. Same form, you can see here and here. So final S not pronounced. Tu pars. Il, elle part. Final T not pronounced. Il, elle part. Okay? So you can see that it's part. Sorry. Part, part, and then part. Okay? So the same phonetical form for these persons, but then obviously and of course for nous it will be different. So classic ending ons, you don't pronounce the s, you just have this on, on sound nasal. Nous partons, nous partons. Okay, then for vous, classic ending for vous as well, a Z, but then you pronounce it E, vous partez, okay, and the last persons, ils, elles, partent, remember, classic ending, E-N-T, but then you don't pronounce them, partent, partent, okay, so let's repeat them again, je pars, tu pars, il part, elle part, nous partons, vous partez, ils partent, elles partent. Bonjour à tous, hi everyone and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 4, leçon J. And in this lesson, we'll discover together how to conjugate at the present form le verbe venir. So, venir means to come. Okay, so it's quite useful, and especially it does belong to the third group of verbs, so it's not regular. So for the present form, it's quite useful to spend a few minutes just to see the conjugation together. Okay, so we'll start right now. First form, je viens. Final S not pronounced. Je viens. Remember, I-E-N, I-E-N, I-E-N. Je viens. Okay. Tu viens. Final S not pronounced. Tu viens. Okay. Then il, elle vient. Final T not pronounced. Il, elle vient. Okay. So je viens, tu viens, il, elle vient. Phonetically, it's the same form. Okay. But then for nous, it will be a bit different. ONS, remember, classic ending for nous. At the present form, final S not pronounced, so you will get the sound venons, nous venons, nous venons. Okay, then classic ending for vous, a Z here, and then you pronounce it et vous venez, okay, and the last one here, so you've got this double N just after the E, so it will change a little bit your pronunciation. You will have to pronounce this like eh, okay? Ils viennent. So remember this classic ending ent for the third person of the plural is here, but phonetically it doesn't exist, so you don't pronounce it. Viennent, viennent, okay? Ils viennent, elles viennent. All right, so let's see the form one more time. Je viens, tu viens, il vient, elle vient, nous venons, vous venez, ils viennent, elles viennent. All right? So, venir is quite important. Be sure to remember it by heart. Please, 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 s'il vous plaît. And then, when you're ready, you can go at the following address to find the next lesson, okay? And then more material here, imagier.net. Have a great day. Au revoir. Les pronoms COD. Okay, so no stress, but still, it will be quite important. Okay, les pronoms COD. So we'll take first a sentence. Okay, so it's a question, and it's tu regardes la télévision. Okay, so tu regardes, regarder is to watch, la télévision. So if we look at this question, okay, and then we want to define all the elements, the first thing that we've got in this sentence is tu. Okay, so it's here, and it's sujet, so the subject of the sentence here. Okay, second part that we've got here is regarde. Okay, regarde here, and it's the verb, okay, that you've been conjugating. It's es just because it's tu, all right? And the second part, or the, sorry, the third part here, so the last part, la télévision. So la télévision, that's what we will call complément, okay, because it's a complement, it will complete the sentence here by giving some information. Its objet, It doesn't have anything to do because it's la télévision, okay? So it's not an object like that, but it's what we call grammatical object, okay? And we say that it's direct because you don't have any preposition between the verb and this complément, okay? So no preposition, so it's direct, okay? So why do we say that it's quite important to use les pronoms COD? Just because when you've got a question, so if someone is asking you, tu regardes la télévision, okay? The first option would be, oui, je regarde la télévision. So of course it's possible to repeat, I mean this part, la télévision, okay? But then if we're honest, then in most of the cases, we won't repeat la télévision in that case. We will use what we call pronouns, okay, just to avoid repeating this word. Okay, so let's see these pronouns together. So as usual, we will have the difference between the masculine, the feminine, and the plural. Okay, in that case, here we'll start with the masculin singulier. Masculin singulier will be first le, or then, as usual, if we've got a vowel coming after, the e will disappear, so it will be l apostrophe. Okay, le, or then l, like that. Okay, if it's feminine, and at the singular form, so we're talking here about the third person of the singular, it will be la. Or, for the same reasons as previously, l apostrophe, if you get a vowel after. Okay? And then for the plural form, so here we're talking about the third person of the plural, then it will be les. Okay, so let's repeat them one more time. So for the masculine singular form, it's le. For the feminine singular form, it's la. Okay, and then if they are followed by vowels, then you take a and a away, and then you get this l, okay? And for the plural form here, it's les. All right? So let's see that in action now. So if you get the same question, tu regardes la télévision? All right? So now we've got all the elements. So we know that tu was the subject, regarde the verb, la télévision, complément d'objet direct, and that's the thing we want to replace. We don't want to repeat la télévision, okay? So first, what do we need to do is first to spot the gender of the word. We know that la télévision is feminine, okay? So we've got all the keys necessary. Oui, je la regarde. So, as I said a long time ago in a lesson, remember that in French, the pronouns, like this one for instance, are coming before the verb. So that's the reason why you will have this la here before the verb. Oui, je la regarde. Okay? Let's take another question. And here you've got tu vas regarder la télévision. So what's the difference between the previous question and this question? Well, this is, and we saw that in a previous lesson, I guess it was on this unit, so you can check it if you're not sure about that. That's what we call the futur proche, so the near future. Tu vas regarder la télévision. You are going to watch. Okay, so that's the near future. Tu vas regarder la télévision. Okay, and then here, if you look carefully, well, you've got two verbs. And that's the important thing here. So if you will have a structure with two verbs, and then you want to use a pronoun, this pronoun will come always before the second verb. Like here, oui, je vais la regarder. Okay? So I'm not telling you that it will come between the two verbs, because you can have many things between these verbs, okay? So focus on this idea that it will come before the second verb. Oui, je vais la regarder. Okay? So we'll see that les pronoms compléments d'objet direct can replace all the persons. So for the first person, it will be me. Second person, it will be te. Third person of the singular, so the one we saw, le for the masculine form, and then la for the feminine form. First person of the plural, nous. So basically, it's quite easy to memorize this one, to remember it. Same thing here. Second person of the plural, vous. And then third person of the plural, les. All right, so me, te, le, la, nous, vous, les. All right? So we'll see now a few examples. So the first one, il me regarde. So if you want to say that he is looking at me, il me regarde. Okay, so remember, as I said previously, these pronouns are coming before the verb. Okay, il me regarde. Present form, only one verb, you just put it before. Il me regarde. Il te regarde. So he's looking at you. Il te regarde. Il le regarde. Il la regarde. He's looking at him, he's looking at her. Il nous regarde. Il vous regarde. Il les regarde. Okay? It's not that difficult. When you try to remember, well, first, of course, the pronouns, and then this idea that it will come before the verb, well, honestly, it's not that tricky, okay? I've been putting the same sentence, but then at this near future form, okay? So just to show you, if you forgot it, that it should come before the second verb, okay? So, il va me regarder. So, he's going to watch me, or to look at me, okay? Il va me regarder. Il va te regarder. Il va le regarder. Il va la regarder. Il va nous regarder. Il va vous regarder. Il va les regarder. Les pronoms COI. Okay, les pronoms COI. So, well, let's say that it's the second part of les pronoms CO, complément d'objet. Okay, so if you didn't watch the previous lesson, well, maybe it would be better to do so that you could understand maybe more clearly the whole thing. Okay, but then still, we're starting right now. So, les pronoms compléments d'objet direct. So, we'll start with une question, a question. Okay, so we'll see. It's a basic question. Okay, you get, tu parles à ton frère. Okay, parler is to talk. Tu parles, you talk, to your brother, à ton frère. Okay, so if we have a look at the elements in this sentence, the first part or the first element is tu, okay, and that's the subject of the sentence, tu, all right? Then the second element is parle, okay? And that's the verb. So it's ending like that because you've been conjugating this verb according to tu, okay? But it's a verb here. And then we've got this last part here, à ton frère. So that's what we call complément. So it will come to complete the sentence, okay? And it's objet, okay? So be careful, it's really what we call a grammatical object. So it's not an object, because in that case, it's a good example because it's a person, okay? But then it's a grammatical object, and it's indirect because you've got this preposition a here, okay? So in the previous lesson, we saw the direct ones, okay? They were without any preposition, okay? But then in this lesson, it's indirect because you've got the preposition a here, okay? And it will change the things. So let's see the question. You can ask the question, so it's the same. Tu parles à ton frère? Okay, and then the answer that you could give, of course, would be oui, je parle à mon frère. But let's say that in most of the cases in French, we won't repeat this à mon frère part. Okay, we'd rather use pronouns just to avoid repeating this complément d'objet indirect. Okay, so we'll see how they go. As usual in French, we will have the difference between the masculine form, the feminine form, and the plural form. Okay, and here, just to start, we'll start with masculine singular. Okay, masculine singular form will be lui. Okay, U-I, lui, lui. All right. Féminin singulier, so feminine form and the singular form here, it will be lui. So it's quite easy to memorize, to remember, okay, because it is the same form for the masculine and the feminine form, okay? And then for the plural form, so third person of the plural, to be more precise, it will be leur, okay? So masculine singular, third person of the singular, lui, féminin singulier, feminine singular form, third person of the singular, lui, and then the plural form, third person of the plural, leur. Okay? Let's see now the same question. Okay? Tu parles à ton frère. Okay? And the idea in that case, of course, is to avoid repeating this part here, so complément d'objet indirect, and to replace it with the pronoun, okay? So first we know that it's indirect because we've got the preposition here. We know here that it's masculine because it's brother, okay? And then we've got the information here because it's ton, all right? So we've got all the elements just to reply using the pronoun. Oui, je lui parle, okay? So the only thing you should really think about here is the position. So you should remember, as I said previously, that the pronouns in French will be placed before the verb. So, je lui parle. Oui, je lui parle. All right? And then we could have, well, basically the same question, but then this question would be like it is here at the near future. So if you didn't see the lesson regarding the near future, maybe it would be more useful for you to watch it. But still, the near future, it's a way to construct the future but at the present tense with the verb aller, to go. You are going to speak or talk, okay, to your brother. Okay, so you are going to, but then the important thing in that case is that you've got two verbs. Okay, you've got aller here, to go, and then you've got parler, to speak or to talk. Okay, and when you've got two verbs, then for the pronoun that you would like to use, you will have to put it just before the second verb. Oui, je vais lui parler. Okay, so I'm not telling you that it should be between, because That's the case here, but then between these two verbs, you could put many, many things, okay, like adverbs or other things, okay? So remember that this pronoun, lui, should be before the second verb, all right? So now we'll see these pronouns, but then for all the persons, okay, for the first person of the singular, it will be me. Second person of the singular, te. Then third person, like we saw, so masculine and feminine, I only put one, so lui, because it's the same. First person of the plural, nous. Second person of the plural, vous. Third person of the plural, leur. Okay? Me, te, lui, nous, vous, leur. All right, so let's see examples now. So he's talking to me. Il me parle. Okay, remember, me, and then before the verb, il me parle. He's talking to you. Il te parle. Il lui parle. I don't know why lui is still white. Well, maybe it was a mistake from my. Yeah, it is a mistake. It should be orange, but then still, il. Lui parle, okay. Il nous parle. Il vous parle. Il leur parle. All right. Il me parle. Il te parle. Il lui parle. Il nous parle. Il vous parle. Il leur parle. Okay. So these examples are with one verb, okay, and then I've been rewriting the same sentence, but then at the near future, okay, with the two verbs, and then we can see how they go now. Il va me parler. He's going to talk to me. Il va me parler. So remember, you know, me before the second verb. Il va te parler. He's going to talk to you. Il va lui parler, he's going to talk to her or he's going to talk to him, okay? Il va nous parler, he's going to talk to us. Il va vous parler, he's going to talk to you. Il va leur parler, he's going to talk to them, okay? Il va me parler, il va te parler, il va lui parler, il va nous parler, il va vous parler, il va leur parler. Bonjour à tous, hi everyone, and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 4, Leçon M. And in this lesson, we'll see how to conjugate together le verbe vouloir. Vouloir means to want, and it belongs to the third group of verbs in French, so irregular. So that's the reason why I think it's quite good to see the conjugation at the present form together. So here it goes. Vouloir. First person, je veux. Final X not pronounced. Je veux. Tu veux. Final X not pronounced. The same form. Il veut. Final T not pronounced. Elle veut. Okay, so here. So far we've got one phonetical form. It's veut. Then for nous, classic ending. O-N-S. Don't pronounce the S. Just pronounce the on. Nous voulons. Nous voulons. Same thing here, classic ending EZ for vous, but then you pronounce it E. Vous voulez. Vous voulez. Vous voulez. And the last one, here EU, E, and then ENT, classic ending, but then you don't pronounce it, so you get veulent. Veulent. Ils veulent. Elles veulent. Ils veulent. Elles veulent. Okay, so let's repeat it one more time. Je veux. Tu veux. Il veut. Elle veut. Nous voulons. Vous voulez. Ils veulent. Elles veulent. So that's it for this lesson. It was a leçon M. Well, you can find more lessons right here. Imagier is the name of the channel on YouTube, and then more material can be found there at imagier.net. Have a great day. Au revoir. Le verbe savoir. Savoir means to know, and it's quite useful. But then it is irregular, so it belongs to the third group of verbs, so it's quite good to see the way to conjugate it together, okay, at the present form. And we'll see it right now. Okay, so let's start now. Je sais. Okay, final S not pronounced. And then you get this A-I-E. Okay, je sais. Sais. Okay. Tu sais. Same form. Final S not pronounced. Tu sais. Il sait. Final T not pronounced. Elle sait. So, one phonetical form so far. Nous savons. So, classic ending for nous, O-N-S. You don't pronounce the final S. Nous savons. Nous savons. Okay? Then, vous savez. Classic ending for vous, E-Z. But then, phonetically, it's E. Vous savez. Savez. And then, il. Here, classic ending for il and elle at the plural form. E-N-T, you don't pronounce it, so you get the sound save, v-v-v-v, save, okay? Ils savent, elles savent. So let's see that one more time. Je sais, tu sais, il sait, elle sait, nous savons, vous savez, ils savent, elles savent. Il y a, so we saw it in a previous lesson quite shortly. So il y a means there is or there are. But then in French, we will have only one form, il y a. Okay, so let's see, for instance, here a question. Est-ce qu'il y a un magasin dans le quartier? Okay, est-ce qu'il y a, so... Is there un magasin, a shop, dans le quartier, in the neighborhood? Okay. Est-ce qu'il y a un magasin dans le quartier? Alright. So the answer would be oui, il est juste ici. Yes, it is right here. Oui, il est juste ici. Okay. So in that case, we've been using this il y a, there is. Okay, just because un magasin, well, it's singular. Okay, so it's basically there is a shop, there is something. Okay, let's see now. Here, same thing. Il y a une piscine, a swimming pool, dans cette ville. Il y a une piscine dans cette ville. All right, so you can see that in the first example, I've been using this est-ce que. You remember, we saw that previously, that you can add if you want to ask a question, okay? Or then it's possible here, just to keep the same order. There is, il y a, okay? Une piscine, a swimming pool, dans cette ville, in this town, okay? But then, don't forget to raise your voice at the end, because it's a question. Il y a une piscine dans cette ville? Il y a une piscine dans cette ville? Okay, just a little bit. To make it clear that it's a question, okay? So answer, oui, elle est à côté de la mairie. À côté, remember, it was next or near, okay? And then la mairie, city hall. Oui, elle est à côté de la mairie. Alright? So in both cases here, il y a, just because it was masculin singulier, okay? And then here, il y a une piscine, féminin singulier. All right, and we'll see now the other option that we would have to ask correctly the question. So first, look at it. Il y a, actually, you should change the order and put it like that. And the way you will pronounce it is y a-t-il, y a-t-il. Okay, so that's the correct form to ask a question with il y a, so the formal form, if you want. And then, des toilettes, here it's the plural form, okay, toilets, okay. So, it doesn't really change because it will stay, il y a, Okay, but then here, of course, the order is changing, so that's the reason why it can be a bit tricky to notify the fact that basically it doesn't change even if it's plural here. Okay, dans ce restaurant, in this restaurant, y a-t-il des toilettes dans ce restaurant? Y a-t-il des toilettes dans ce restaurant? Okay, and then the answer, oui, elles sont juste à droite. Okay, droite, remember, it was on the right. À droite, on the right. Just on the right. Oui, elles sont juste à droite. Okay, so to resume the whole thing, remember this il y a will be used so for there is, so like here, un magasin, a shop, so it's the singular form, okay, or then here as well, il y a, there is, une piscine, a swimming pool, but still it will be also used as like that, il y a, okay, or then in the other order here, for the plural form, okay, it doesn't change. So that's one interesting thing in French. For once, it's easy, it doesn't change, il y a plus singulier, or then il y a plus pluriel, okay?